congruence relation. Fix an integer n greater than 1. That is, n is a positive integer greater than 1. For integers x and y, we define x is congruent to y mod n if and only if n divides x minus y. In this case, we say that x is congruent to y mod n and written as x is congruent to y mod n. The equivalence class of x is sometimes called the residue class of x mod n. This notation was first introduced by Carl F. Gauss, 1777 to 1855, who is regarded by many as one of the top mathematicians of all times. At the age of 23, he wrote Disquisitions Arithmeticae, which started. This notation was first introduced by Carl F. Gauss, 1777 to 1855, who is regarded by many as one of the top mathematicians of all times. At the age of 23, he wrote a book which started a new era of number theory and introduced this notation, definition of congruence modulo m. Let a comma b belong to z, that is a and b are any two integers, may be positive, negative, even zero, and m be a fixed positive integer, so m must be positive. If a minus b is divisible by m, when we say divisible, the remainder is 0. We say that a is congruent to b modulo m, and we write it as a is congruent to b mod m. This is a symbol. This relation between integers a and b is called congruence modulo m. Thus, a is congruent to b mod m implies and implied by m divides a minus b, or m divides b minus a. When you say divides, the symbol for divides, that is when a minus b is divided by m, the remainder is 0. Or a minus b is equals to q into m for some integer q. Example, 22 is congruent to what number modulo m? Now what do you do? We have to divide 22 by 9. When we divide 22 by 9, what is the remainder? That is, what is the remainder when 22 is divided by 9? It is clear that 2 9s are 18. And 22 minus 18 gives 4. That is, 4 is the remainder. That is the answer here. So 22 is congruent to 4 mod 9. As 9 divides a minus b. M divides a minus b. Here m is 9. A is 22. B is 4. Therefore, m divides a minus b means 9 divides 22 minus 2 minus 4, that is 9 divides 22 minus 4 is 18. Exactly 9 divides 18, that is 18 is divided by 9, the remainder is 0. Here the element b is not unique, that is 4 is not unique. We can have any other number also, it is not unique. For example, the value of 4 will be 13 also. The value of 4 will be 13 because 9 divides 24 minus 13. That is 9 divides 9. In the place of 4, we can have a 13. In the place of 4, we can have a 22 also. Because 9 divides 22 minus 22, that is 9 divides 0. That's true. In the place of 4, we can have a minus 5 also. Because 22 minus of minus 5 is 27. 9 divides 27. Because 9 threes are 27. We can also have minus 14. The reason is 9 divides 22 minus of minus 14, that is minus of minus is plus, 22 minus of minus is plus, 14 is 36, 9 divides 36, 9 fours are 36. Therefore, the number B here, the 4 is not unique. In the place of 4, you can have a 4 or 13 or 12, 22 or minus 5 or minus 9, 14, so on. You simply add 9. Because 4 plus 9 is 13, 13 plus 9 is 22, so on. Or 4 minus 9 is minus 5, minus 5 minus 9 is minus 14. Once you know this number, you simply go on, add this number or minus of this number. 4 plus 9 is 13, 13 plus 9 is 22, so on. 4 minus 9 is minus 5, minus 5 minus 9 is minus 14, so on. Therefore, here B is not unique. What is the value of here? Minus 1 is congruent to what number mod 4? That is, when minus 1 is divided by 4, what is the remainder? It is 3. We can have many more values, but the least value is 3. The reason is 4 divides minus 1 minus 3, that is minus 4. 4 divides minus 4 is right. Therefore, the values of A and B can be any integers, positive, negative, even 0. But this number M must be positive integer. So these are some examples of congruent. Note, the operation congruence modulo M is an equivalence relation on the set of integers. What is an equivalence relation? A relation E on a set S is called an equivalence relation on S if it is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. For simplicity's sake, we can say equivalence relation is TRS. T stands for transitive, R stands for reflexive, S stands for S. Simply, we can remember TRS for equivalence relation. The relation on a set is called an equivalence relation if the relation is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. The operation congruence modulo M partitions the set of integer Z into disjoint equivalent classes called residue classes modulo M or congruence classes modulo M. What are the applications? Modular arithmetic is one of the foundations of number theory, touching on almost every aspects of its study and provides key examples for group theory, ring theory, and abstract algebra. Modular arithmetic, this is a congruence relation, is often used to calculate checksums that are used within identifiers. International bank account numbers, IBANs, for example, make use of modulo 97 arithmetic to trap users' input errors in bank account numbers. In computer algebra, modular arithmetic is commonly used to limit the size of integer coefficients in indeterminate calculations and data. It is used in polynomial factorization, a problem for which all known efficient algorithms use modular arithmetic. it is used by the most efficient implementations of polynomial greatest common divisor, exact linear algebra and basis algorithms over the integers and the rational numbers. In computer science, the modular arithmetic is often applied in bitwise operations and other operations involving fixed width cyclic data structures. The modulo operation, as implemented in many programming languages and calculators, is an application of modular arithmetic that is often used in this contest. XOR is the sum of two bits modulo 2. In chemistry, the last digit of the CAS registry number, a number which is unique for each chemical compound, is a check digit, which is calculated by taking the last digit of the first two parts of the CAS registry number times 1, the next digit times 2, the next digit times 3, etc., adding all these up and computing the sum modulo 10. In music, arithmetic modulo 12 is used in the consideration of the system of 12 tone equal temperament, where octave and enharmonic equivalency occurs, that is, pitches in a 1:2 or 2:1 ratio are equivalent, and C sharp is considered the same as D flat. The method of costing out nines offers a quick check of decimal arithmetic computations performed by hand. It is based on modular arithmetic modulo 9 and especially on the crucial property that 10 is congruent to 1 mod 9. Arithmetic modulo 7 is used in algorithms that determine the day of the week for a given date. More generally, modular arithmetic also has application in disciplines such as law, economics, game theory, and other areas of the social sciences where proportional division and allocation of resources plays a central part of the analysis. Suppose when you book a ticket in railway, your berth number is 27 in second class sleeper. Which is your berth? Upper berth, lower berth, or middle berth, or side lower, or side upper? What shall we do? Just divide 27 by 8. Why? Because a compartment consists of 8 berths, will have a lower berth. 1 stands for lower berth, 2 stands for middle, 3 for upper. Similarly, 4 stands for lower in the opposite side, 5 stands for middle in the opposite side, and 6 stands for upper in the other side, 7 stands for side lower, and number 8 stands for side upper. So we have a 8 berth in a compartment. So here we have to use arithmetic modulo 8. So divide 27 by 8, we get the remainder is 3, and the 3 stands for upper, and hence your berth is upper berth. So once you know the berth number, divide the berth number by 8. The remainder gives whether it's a middle berth or upper berth or side upper, side lower, etc. Definition of addition modulo M. Let small a and b belong to set of integers and small m be a fixed positive integer. If r is the remainder, 0 less than equals to r less than m, when A plus B, the ordinary sum of A and B, is divided by M. We define A addition modulo M. This is symbol for addition modulo M. B is equals to R. We read as A addition modulo M B. For example, what is the value of 32 addition modulo 5, 4? What do you have to do? Adding 32 and 4. If you add 32 and 4, we get 36. Now divide 36 by 5. What is the remainder? It is clearly 1. And hence, 32 addition modulo 5, 4 is equals to 1. Similarly, 6 addition modulo 5, 7 equal to 3. Because 6 plus 7 is 13. When 13 is divided by 5, 3 is the remainder. 4 plus 8 is 12. When 12 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. What is the value of minus 30 addition modulo 3, 5? When you add minus 30 and 5, we get minus 25. Then what's the answer? The answer is 2. The reason is minus 30 plus 5 is minus 25. Minus 25 can be written as minus 9 into 3. 3 is addition modulo plus 2, because minus 27 plus 2 is minus 25, and this 2 gives the answer. Or the simple idea is minus 30 plus addition modulo 3, 5 is congruent to, when you add this minus 30 and 5, we get minus 25. That is, minus 25 is 25 modulo 3, which is congruent to and almost equal to. When you divide minus 25 by 3, we know minus 8 times 3 or minus 24. So the remainder is minus 1, and hence minus 1 mod 3. But what is the remainder here? Remainder is minus 1. But the remainder supposed to be a positive number or even 0. The remainder cannot be negative value. This cannot be negative value. It must be positive value, less than M, or even 0. Then what shall we do now? For this, we simply add 3 to the remainder. Whatever the mod is there, we simply add that number to the remainder. Therefore, minus 1 plus 3, that gives 2. And hence, 2 is the answer. Because the remainder must be non-negative number. Note, A addition modulo M B is equals to B addition modulo M into A. And this important note, A plus B is less than M. When the sum is less than M, then we can write A addition modulo M B is same as A plus B. For example, 2 addition modulo 9, 5 is equal to 7. Because 2 plus 5 is 7. And 7 is less than this M. 7 is less than this M. There is A plus B is less than M. Whenever A plus B is less than M, we simply write A plus B, that is 7. Now definition, set of integer suffix M is equals to 0, 1, 2, so on, M minus 1. That is, Z suffix M stands for all the non-negative integers less than this number, less than the suffix, minus 1. That is, set of all non-negative integers less than this number, that stands for Z suffix M. That is 0, 1, 2, so on, M minus 1, is called the complete set of least positive residue modulo M, or simply set of residue classes modulo M. The set of residue classes modulo M is an abelian group of order M with respect to addition of residue classes. The set of residue classes modulo M is an abelian group of order M with respect to the operation addition modulo M. Let G be The set consists of 0, 1, 2, so on, m minus 1. Let G be the set consisting of m elements, namely 0, 1, 2, so on, m minus 1, because set of residue classes modulo m consists of m elements. They are m non-negative integers less than m. M non-negative integers less than m. They are nothing but 0, 1, 2 up to m minus 1. Now we have to show that this G forms an abelian group with respect to addition modulo m. If a and b are integers and m is a positive integer, then a plus b, a addition modulo m b is equals to r, where r is the remainder when a plus b is divided by m. Yeah, this is the definition. A addition modulo m b equal to r, where r is the remainder when a plus b is divided by m. For example, 3 addition modulo 2, 4 equal to dash. That is, we have to add 3 and 4. When you add 3 and 4, we get 7. When 7 is divided by 2, the remainder is 1. Therefore, 1 is the answer, because 1 is the remainder when 3 plus 4 equal to 7 is divided by 2. Then 5 addition modulo 4, 21. A is 5, B is 21, M is 4. We have to find R. What is R? R is the remainder when A plus B, that is 5 plus 21, is divided by M, that is 4. 5 plus 21 is 26. When 26 is divided by 4, 2 is the remainder. Therefore, 2 is the remainder when 26 is divided by 4. 2 addition modulo 7, 3 equal to dash. What is the value? Here A is 2, B is 3, M is 7. And remember that A plus B is 5, which is less than M. Just now we discussed, whenever A plus B is less than M, then A addition modulo M B is nothing but A plus B. Therefore, here it is 5. 2 plus 3 equal to 5. The reason is, A addition modulo M B is equal to A plus B if A plus B is less than M. And 5 addition modulo 8, 3 equals to 0. That is, when 5 plus 3, that is 8, 8 is divided by 8, it is 0. Clearly, R is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to M minus 1. That is, 0 less than or equal to R less than or equal to M minus 1. The reason is, in this example, R equal to 1, M is 2. Therefore, M minus 1 will be 2 minus 1 is 1. R is 1, M minus 1. M minus 1 is 1. Therefore, R equals to M minus 1. It is true. In the second example, 5 addition modulo 4, 21 equal to 2. What is R here? R is 2, M is 4, therefore M minus 1 is 3. So R is 2, M minus 1 is 3, and hence 2 is less than 3. Yeah, it is true. This is also true. In the third example, 2 plus 3 addition modulo 7 equal to 5. Here R equal to 5, M is equals to 7, M minus 1 is equal to 6. Therefore, R is 5, M minus 1 is 6, and hence 5 is less than 6. It is also true. In the last case, R equal to 0, M is equal to 8, and M minus 1 equal to 7, and again 0 is less than 7, as well as R equals to 0. Thus, R can be 0, R more than 0, but less than or equal to M minus 1. Yeah, clearly R is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equals to M minus 1. Closure property. A comma B belong to G implies A addition modulo M B belongs to G is the closure property. That is, if we take any two elements from G, that is 0 to M minus 1, then A addition modulo M B must be any one of these elements. We will verify this. Since A addition modulo M B equal to R and R is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to M minus 1, this implies R belongs to G. Yeah, by definition of addition modulo M, R, A addition modulo M B is R. What is R? R is from 0 to M minus 1. What are the elements of G? 0 to M minus 1. Therefore, this R is any one of these elements of G and hence R belongs to G. But what is R? R is nothing but A addition modulo M B. Therefore, whenever A comma B belong to G, A addition modulo M B belongs to G and hence G is closed with respect to addition modulo M. Associativity. Normally, whenever whatever is in the bracket, we will simplify first. Therefore, A addition modulo M B plus addition modulo M C is equals to, here A addition modulo M B is same as A plus B mod M. We have a result. Therefore, in the place of A addition modulo M B, we are going to write A plus B. We are going to write A plus B here. Yeah, that's the one. A plus B addition modulo M into C. Now consider this is like A. This is like small a. This is another element like B. What is A addition modulo M into B? We know A addition modulo M into B is the remainder when A plus B is divided by M. And hence, we can write that is equals to remainder when A plus B plus C is divided by M. Here, we apply the definition of addition modulo M. Because A addition modulo M B is the remainder when A plus B is divided by M. Therefore, since we apply the definition of addition modulo M, when you write in terms of the sentence, we simply remove addition modulo M by plus symbol. Therefore, A plus B addition modulo M C is nothing but the remainder when A plus B plus C is divided by M. That is equals to the remainder when A plus B plus C is divided by M. Why? What are A, B, C? A, B, C are integers and we know that set of integers obey associative property with respect to addition. And hence this A plus B plus C can witness A plus B plus C. But what is this? We are going to replace the sentence by the symbol, mathematical symbols. Therefore, this can be written as A plus B addition modulo M into C. Because whenever we rewrite, we simply replace the symbol. And hence, this equals to A addition modulo M into B plus addition modulo M. That is equals to A addition modulo M B addition modulo C. Thus A addition modulo M B plus addition modulo M C is equal to A addition modulo M B addition modulo M into C. Thus G satisfies associative law with respect to addition modulo M. Existence of identity. We have A addition modulo M 0 equals to A, that is equal to 0 addition modulo M into A. Because The result says that the identity axiom says that A star E equal to A equal to E star A, where star is a binary operation, whereas in this problem addition modulo M is a binary operation. Clearly 0 satisfies this identity, and hence here E is equals to 0, therefore E equal to 0, and hence A addition modulo M equal to A equal to 0 plus addition modulo M into A. That is, when you add any element with 0, we get the same element. We get the same element, and hence E equal to 0, and 0 is the identity element in G with respect to addition modulo M. Now inverse element. We are going to find the inverse of each and every element in G. The inverse axiom says that for all A belongs to G, there exists A inverse belongs to G such that A addition modulo M A inverse is equals to E. Actually E, but E is 0 here. That's equal to A inverse plus addition modulo M into A. Now we are going to find the inverse of every element. How many elements are there in G? There are M elements. What is the value of M? M can be 5, M can be 7, M can be 10, M can be 100, M can be 1 lakh, M can be 1 crore, but it is finite. Suppose M is 200, then how we are going to find the inverse of each and every element of G? That is 200 elements. It will take a long time. Therefore, we are going to use a mathematical idea. For this, first we consider the zero element. Then we consider non-zero elements. Clearly, 0 addition modulo M, 0 equal to 0 equal to 0 addition modulo M equal to 0. That is, we take 0 as the element of A and add with 0, we get the same element 0. And hence, here this 0 plays a role of inverse of 0. Therefore, the inverse of 0 is 0. We know the inverse of identity element in any group is itself. Therefore, the inverse of 0 is 0. Thus, we consider 0 element. Now, we have to consider non-zero element. How many non-zero elements are there in G? There are M minus 1 non-zero elements. What are they? 1, 2, 3 up to M minus 1. We are going to find the inverse of these non-zero elements. For that, we choose one arbitrary element. If R is not equal to 0, belongs to G. That is, R is a non-zero element of G. We know that G has M elements, namely from 0, 1, 2 up to M minus 1. Then, suppose if we take M is equal to 20 and the elements of G are 1, 2, 3, so on, M minus 1. Therefore, G will be having 20 elements, namely 0, 1, 2, M minus 1 is 19. And hence, we count, will be having 20 elements from 0 to 19. Just now, we have found the inverse of 0. Inverse of 0 is itself, because 0 is the identity and the inverse of identity element in any group is itself. Now, we are going to find the inverse of 1, 2, up to 19. We cannot get every number. Suppose M is 200. We cannot find the inverse of all the elements. 1, 2, 3, so on. Now what we do? We apply a mathematical idea. For that sake, we take one arbitrary non-zero element in G. That is, R is not equal to 0, belongs to G. It means R can be any number from 1 to 19. In the case of M equal to 20. Now, suppose R equals to 5, which is non-zero, right? 5 is in G. Now, what is the value of M minus R? M minus R will be 15, because 20 minus 5 is 15. Clearly, 15 also in G, because G has from 0 to 19. 15 is here, before 16. Okay, so M minus R belongs to G. So, if R is non-zero element belongs to G, then M minus R must be in G. With this example, you can understand this concept. Now, what is R addition modulo M? M minus R. By definition, this addition modulo M symbol is replaced and write the definition, the remainder, when R plus M minus R is divided by M. That is, the addition modulo M symbol is replaced. This is by definition. When you say A addition modulo M B, there is a remainder when A plus B is divided by M. Here A is R, B is M minus R. What is the value of R plus M minus R? R minus R get cancelled. Hence, we have remainder when M is divided by M. When M is divided by M, what is the remainder? 0. Because 5 is divided by 5, remainder is 0. When 20 is divided by 20, the remainder is 0. Therefore, the answer is 0. What is 0? This 0 is the identity element in G. Now, let us find the other way. M minus R, addition modulo M, R. By definition of addition modulo, that is equal to remainder when M minus R plus R is divided by M. The value of M minus R plus R is M, because minus R plus R get cancelled. The remainder when M is divided by M. When M is divided by M, the remainder is 0. Thus, M minus R addition modulo M R is equal to 0. The 0 is the identity. This shows that the inverse of R is M minus R. This shows that the inverse of M minus R is R. Thus, what is R? R is any non-zero element in G. If 0 is the element, its inverse is 0. If R is any non-zero element of G, then its inverse will be M minus R. Take the same example, M equal to 20, R equal to 5. What is the inverse of R? The inverse of R is 15, because R equal to 5. Its inverse equal to M minus R. What is M minus R? 15. Therefore, inverse of 5 is 15. What's the inverse of 15? 5. Now, R equal to 2. What is the inverse of 2? Inverse of 2 is M is 20, R is 2. Therefore, 20 minus 2 is 18. So, inverse of 2 is 18. What's the inverse of 10? 20 minus 10 is 10. What's the inverse of 7? 20 minus 7 is 13. What's the inverse of 6? 20 minus 6 is 14. This is how we can find the inverse of each and every element of G. Thus, inverse axiom is verified. That is, M minus R is the inverse of R in G with respect to addition modulo M. Therefore, every element in G is invertible. Now, the last one is commutativity. For that, we have to show that for all A comma B belong to G, then A addition modulo M B is equals to B addition modulo M A. What is A addition modulo M B? By definition of addition modulo, that is equals to the remainder when A plus B is divided by M. The remainder when A plus B is divided by M. What are A and B? A and B are elements of G. What are they? They are integers. And we know that set of integers obey commutative property with respect to addition. Therefore, in the place of A plus B, we can write B plus A. Hence, remainder when B plus A is divided by M. Remember that here in A addition modulo M B, we have written A first followed by B. Now here, what is written first? B is written first, then A. Therefore, the remainder when B plus A is divided by M can be replaced by the mathematical expressions, namely B addition modulo M A. Thus, A comma B belong to G implies A addition modulo M B equals to B addition modulo M into A. Therefore, G satisfies commutative law with respect to addition modulo M. And hence, G satisfies all the five axioms, namely closure, associative identity, inverse and commutativity. Hence, the algebraic structure G addition modulo M is an abelian group.